U.S. President Joe Biden meets with Canada's Justin Trudeau and Mexico's Manuel López Obrador in a bid to revitalize regional cooperation overshadowed by tensions over Biden's Buy American agenda and immigration. This is the first North American summit in 5 years. The talks were also aimed at finding common ground on the U.S.-Mexico-Canada Free Trade Agreement, which governs some $1.5 trillion of trade per year. Migration and pandemic recovery were also on the agenda.
So today, it's about what we can do in partnership and mutual respect to strengthen our region and prove democracies can deliver in the second quarter of the 21st century, including by increasing supply chain resilience and reliance, worker protections, improving cybersecurity, and helping small and medium businesses thrive in the Northern Hemisphere.
Our highest priority is, of course, ending COVID-19 and being focused on economic recovery, strengthened supply chains. We're making sure that our integrated North American economy produces good jobs and supports the middle class in our three countries. This will be underpinned by a world-class trade agreement that protects workers' rights. We're ready to continue working together on the climate crisis.
The U.S. considering to boycott the 2022 Winter Olympics in Beijing. That's according to U.S. President Biden. The move aims to protest China's human rights practices. Washington is accusing China of carrying out a genocide against Muslim ethnic groups in its western Xinjiang region. But Beijing denies this. Activists and some members of Congress have been pressing the Biden administration to diplomatically boycott the sporting event, which is scheduled to kick off in February next year. Switching gears now, it seems that the art market is not yet ready to fully embrace the crypto craze. A group called Constitution DAO sought to buy a rare copy of the U.S. Constitution after crowdfunding a whopping $46 million for the document, or around 11,500 Ether. But it was outbid by an unknown buyer for $43 million. It's a good thing, though, because if they won the bid, thousands of investors who comprise the group would not have received fractional ownership of the document. The group says those who chipped in will be refunded. The U.S. asks big Asian oil buyers, including China, Japan, and India, to tap their reserves to help cool global oil prices. The details in this report.
U.S. President Joe Biden is seeking action to cool rising prices for crude. Reuters sources say Washington has asked big Asian buyers of oil to consider tapping their reserves to take the pressure off supplies. The request was reportedly aimed at countries including India, Japan, and, for the first time, China. Benchmark oil prices fell as much as 4% following the Reuters report before recovering much of the losses. Analysts say the U.S. request is a rare move that reflects frustration with OPEC. The oil producers group has rebuffed calls to increase output to cool off prices, though it has gradually reversed the record cuts to production it made last year. Now, a coordinated release involving China would mark an unprecedented challenge to OPEC. Beijing's State Reserve Bureau says it is working on releasing some reserves, but wouldn't comment on the U.S. request. A Japanese official said that, by law, the country cannot release reserves in order to move prices. In South Korea, an official confirmed that it, too, had received the U.S. request. Reuters sources say Biden and top aides have discussed a coordinated release with allies over the past few weeks, but OPEC remains resistant to big moves. It says the rebound in demand for oil could prove fragile, and says there are already signs of a surplus building up next year.
A new study shows Facebook ran paid climate denial advertisements during the crucial two-week negotiations at the COP26 summit in Glasgow. Here's the full story.
As world leaders gathered in Glasgow earlier this month for a global climate summit, Facebook's top public affairs executive said the social media giant was committed to combating global warming and pledged to crack down on misinformation about the science of climate change.
We also have a responsibility to tackle climate misinformation on our services.
But just days later, the conservative media network Newsmax ran an ad on Facebook that called man-made global warming a hoax. The ad, which had multiple versions, garnered more than 200,000 views. In another ad, conservative commentator Candace Owens wrote, quote, "Apparently, we're just supposed to trust our new authoritarian government when it comes to all science, including the science on the climate crisis." And a libertarian think tank ran an ad on how, quote, "modern doomsayers had been wrongly predicting climate crises for decades." Facebook, which recently changed its name to Meta, does not have a specific policy on climate misinformation in ads or unpaid posts, but it says advertisers that repeatedly post false information may face restrictions on their ability to advertise on Facebook. Asked about ads pushing climate misinformation, a company spokesperson said in a statement, quote, "While ads like these run across many platforms, Facebook offers an extra layer of transparency by requiring them to be available to the public in our ad library for up to 7 years after publication."
You guys are allowing that kind of misinformation around climate.
Just as the climate summit was kicking off, Reuters reporter Elizabeth Culliford spoke with Facebook Chief Technology Officer Mike Schrupfer about where he thought Facebook still fell short on climate issues.
Obviously, I've been concerned about people sharing misinformation about climate on Facebook. There's been a huge issue of misinformation more broadly.
Schrupfer did not directly answer why Facebook had not banned all advertisements with climate misinformation, but said it, quote, "didn't want people to profit over misinformation."